So the next thing we're going to tackle is ovarian cysts. Do you know that if you have a period, you will develop ovarian cysts in your lifetime? You may not feel it or know that you have one, or you might feel like this. Take a look at this video from blogger Lauren McPhillips. She is writhing in pain. You look at it and you just think, this looks excruciating. And what I think is probably the worst thing about this video is there are viewers at home that probably think this is normal. They go through it and they probably think this is normal. So we want to break this down. Lauren is joining us now along with Dr. Marjorie Dixon. And I want to start with you, Lauren. Thank you for that video. You shared that video on social media a few months ago, and documenting it like that really just puts it into perspective what this could feel like. Can you tell us about your experience with ovarian cysts? There have been multiple, right?
So the first time it happened was actually back in 2018, and I wrote a blog post about it afterwards, and I've talked about it regularly on my social media, and I did a TEDx talk about it, just because I think it needs to be something that's talked about quite a bit more. Mm-hmm. But essentially what had happened was I was working out, and I felt a sharp pain in my abdomen. And within 5 minutes, that turned into an excruciating pain. Mm-hmm. I wasn't able to walk. I was vomiting. I had diarrhea. I was in cold sweats. And that lasted for about an hour and a half. And then afterwards, I was kind of left just wondering what just happened to me. And so I had set up an appointment with my doctor, and it kind of took a couple of times for him to then recommend me to an OBGYN and get some tests done. And when I did get the tests done, they did confirm that a cyst had ruptured on my ovary. And I had a ton of questions, you know, like, would this happen again? Can I prevent this? And really the only answer that I got was that it probably will happen again, that it's something that's very common. And that the only way that I could kind of lessen the chances of it is getting pregnant or going back on birth control. And those were two things that I really didn't want to do.
Well, gee, thanks, Doc. I mean, yes, you've got a ruptured cyst, and yeah, it's probably going to happen again, and good luck to you. Now, do you feel, Lauren, that there are enough mm-hmm. conversations out there about irregular periods and ovarian cysts?
I think that the conversations are starting to happen more and more on social media as like women and trans men and non-binary people are kind of opening up about their own personal experiences, and a lot of people are resonating with it and feel comfortable talking about it as well. But in the mainstream, I don't think it's spoken about even close to enough. And I think it's because, you know, there's a lot of people that are experiencing this debilitating pain that's happening every month. And we've kind of been fed this narrative that period pain is just, you know, part of being a woman. But what that then leads to is feelings of shame and guilt and inadequacy when you are having to remove yourself from social situations or when it comes to taking time off of work.
Absolutely. And when I saw that video, the first thing I thought of, it looked like food poisoning. When you've had food poisoning, and then when mm-hmm. you mentioned like you felt like nauseous and diarrhea and like the whole nine, nobody wants to have to go through that. And the sad thing is that there are viewers going through that and thinking that it's normal and it should not be normalized. So I'm going to go to Dr. Marjorie Dixon now. Can you talk about how ovarian cysts are formed? What are the causes?
So ovarian cysts are fluid-filled sacs that happen in the ovary. And you can get cysts, fluid-filled cysts anywhere in your body, but the ovarian cysts that we're talking about are not always the same. But Lauren was absolutely right, and you were right when you mentioned that we're entitled to have cysts during our reproductive lifespans, ages 13 to 51, because every single month when we get our period, our brain and our ovaries are communicating to recruit an egg to ovulation, and that happens in a follicular cyst. So obligately, every single month, as you're getting ready to ovulate, you have a cyst growing on your ovary. Now, we have to qualify that cyst as they're small. And then in the middle of the cycle, when the cyst ruptures and the egg comes out, most people don't feel a thing. And that actually, there's a term for it. It's called middle schmerz, middle pain. What Lauren is talking about is when you have one of these follicular cysts, a functional ovarian cyst that happens normally every month, generally, but that grows and that the egg doesn't necessarily come out of it right away. So these functional follicular cysts can hang out for a couple of months. Mm. Sometimes they swell, and sometimes they just regress on their own and they go away. But when they rupture, that's a problem. And that's where women feel excruciating pain. It's really important to know that there are a variety of cysts, and they can behave very well, but then they can also rupture and cause problems. And those require medical attention and intervention.
Now, I just want to mention transgender men, non-binary people, as Lauren mentioned, can also go through all of this because, of course, the reproductive hardware is there. So what should we be aware of if we've never experienced this? Are there signs? Are they the same for everyone, Dr. Dixon?
Well, so there are signs. If you are feeling particular pain mid-cycle or through your menstrual cycle, if you are feeling full in your pelvis and you haven't felt that way before, if you have pain that started as something that was little, but month after month it seems to be increasing and it lateralizes, it's on one side in particular, if during penetrative intercourse you feel pain as well, those are not normal things, and you have to be in touch with your body to be able to say, well, I've never felt this before, but this feels different. And unfortunately, you have to advocate for yourself, because as a female gynecologist, fertility specialist, I see a lot of patients that accept a lot of pain and abnormality. The keep calm, carry on is not what you should do with your reproductive organs, because it can have an impact on your future fertility. It can have an impact on your just general activities of daily living. You should not have to be in that kind of pain on a monthly or ever basis. It is all manageable, and it's up to the healthcare professional to work through the differential diagnosis and then come up with the best case management.
I'll give you props to Dr. Dixon, because you've been saying this on our show for years. If you are having pain, do not normalize it. Advocate for yourself. And I want Lauren to get the last word in there. What do you feel our healthcare system needs to do more of to support these issues?
Well, first of all, I think everyone needs a Dr. Dixon in their lives, because it really is, as Dr. Dixon had said, you really do need to advocate for yourself. And that's kind of what I found, is that I've had to advocate for myself, do all of my own research. I've worked with some great naturopaths, but that's all been out of pocket. And I just think there needs to be more resources available, and just more accessible information and accessible resources for people who aren't as lucky as me.